There's a fever hitting California.
So gold fever, that's what it is.
And it seems to be spreading.
I think I love gold. Oh, I've had the fever for many, many moons. You know, it's incurable.
There's plenty of gold, so I've been told. On the
they came for the gold in the 19th century, and they are back for it now. Gold digging clubs just like this, taking to creeks.
I said, this stuff right here is some pretty rich stuff.
Hoping nature will give her treasure up if they put the effort in.
This looks like exhausting work.
It is. You gotta love what you do. You're moving a lot of tonnage of rocks. They say if you want to find an ounce of gold, you gotta move 100 yards of dirt.
So why do people do it then? Because there are easier ways to get rich quick, aren't there?
For the glory of finding the big one.
Up until fairly recently, a lot of these creeks were completely dry, but not anymore. We had a lot of rain here in California at the start of the year. Couple that with the record snowmelt in the mountains. The water is cascading down here. It's disturbing rock. It's washing the gold to ground level where pretty much anybody can find it as long as they have enough time, the right equipment, and crucially, they've got enough patience as well.
It's kind of like the lotto, one of these days.
They work together, but for themselves, every one of them hoping they have picked the perfect spot this day.
You have some places where you're going to get pretty good gold, and other places you don't get anything. But you still go back out and try it again, a different spot.
Watching, waiting for that telltale glint. It could make their day. It could change their lives.
And that's not a bad little piece.
Unlikely, sure, but still possible.
I've been doing it for about 4 years, and I'm lucky if I broke an ounce.
But one day, right?
That's a lot of gas. That's a lot of gas. I go back and forth, but you're going to stay home and watch TV? Ah, that don't get you nowhere.
And those gains, however small, are fueling an economy.
Since gold went over $1,000, people have been going after it pretty hard.
Just ask Sal. He's the guy buying a lot of this gold. His door barely has time to close these days.
It's more than a hobby for a lot of people. It's an income for some of them, for sure. And I have people selling me their gold on a weekly basis.
Is this a fad that's going to die out?
I don't think it's going to ever die out. There's gold still to be found. I think there's more gold left than was ever found.
Of course, this state has a soft spot for this soft metal. It's where the original gold rush began. And while history may not repeat itself, at least not on that scale, they'll keep trying.
You see gold like that. You pull it out of your pan, you get a smile on your face, and you just start digging again. No matter how hard you've dug during the day, no matter how hard you've worked, you see a smile like that, you keep working.
Because maybe, just maybe, it could be their day. Phil Lavelle, CGTN, near Yosemite National Park in Northern California.